What are, do you guys have a specific writing process? Like, if you have an idea, do you immediately get a pen and paper, or do you like to let it soak and just, like, can you tell us how it sort of comes out onto the page?
How it vomits on.
I'm a big, I give my ideas the brush off quite frequently. Never fails, like clockwork, I'll be in the middle of whatever I'm working on, mm-hmm. and a new idea will pop up. So I give it the brush, and I just get the frick away from me. I don't care what you're doing. And look at me, look at me, look at me.
I'm pretty angry.
I don't care. I don't care what the heck is going on with you. Please shut up. But at the same time, I kind of know, like, that's what I'm going to be doing next, so I can't be too mean to it. But the best ideas, it's, Stephen King has this file cabinet metaphor where he says he has a ton of ideas and they all go into the mental file cabinet, and whatever one's going to be written next just keep popping to the front. You know, you keep closing the file cabinet and you, whatever's going to happen keeps popping to the front. And the bad ones fall away and the good ones won't go away. So that's pretty much how it works. And once I figure out what that good idea is, good, whatever, the idea that I'm working on is, I'll usually think about it a lot, get to know the characters, maybe play out, you know, 5 or 6 scenes from random spaces, and they'll just kind of play out in my head like movies, and then I'll find where it starts. I will have no idea where it ends or how it gets there, but once I find the start, then I know it's time to write. Mm-hmm.
I also get ideas when I'm writing something, and the more difficult the book is that I'm writing, the more ideas, like, vie for attention. So I had a bunch while I was writing this, and the book that I'm editing right now, it's the same thing. I had like 4 fantastic book ideas in the last month. It was ridiculous. Normally what I do is I open a Word document, I title it something, and I'm like, I want to write a book about blah, 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 and it has this kind of character, and it takes place here. And then I just save it and close it, and so, like, the file cabinet's like a physical one. And then I'll go to Amazon and make a wish list of, like, research books for, like, that shiny idea. And then when I get around to having time to do it, if the books in the research file still seem interesting to me, then I'll start and do some research, but sometimes they don't. Like you said, it's like, oh, I've got this great idea about, like, unicorns in the Sahara. Unicorns, like, it's such a great idea, and it never, you can never make that work. It's like, it's My Little Ponies, but they wear shoes. I don't know. And it sounds like the best idea ever when you think of it, and then you're like, this has no legs whatsoever. There's no story here. There's no character here. I also like to, like mill around in published books and see if anyone's sort of done it yet. I don't want to be the 5th girl writing a Houdini book, you know. if all of the others are going to come out before me, it might affect my desire to write the story at that point. Because
see, it never fails for me. It seems like as soon as I'm done with the book, I'll look and see there are like 9 other books coming out just like it.
Yeah, but after.
But after. Like, oh, frick. Why do I have the worst timing? No.
It's good if yours comes out first. Then you're at the top. You're at the top of that wave. You're riding the crest, hopefully. yeah, I don't know what I'm gonna do after what I'm doing now. But there's like 5 ideas sitting on the table, just in case. I'll never wait.
Oh, my phone's gonna die.
Awesome.
That's sad.
In the back.
Now that you are multi-published authors, are you able to sell like books on concepts, or do you still like present a completed novel to you?
Good question.
What'd you do?
Well, my agent and I actually just had this conversation, and she said, you know, you don't need a whole book. You can just do sample chapters and a synopsis. And I said, knowing that I'm never going to do that. I do not have enough confidence in my stupid ideas. Like, it has to make it to at least the 35,000 word mark before I realize, yeah, it is actually going to go the length of a novel. It's not just going to stall out at 35,000 words. and I would feel terrible if I sold somebody something on the chapter.
Yeah.
Like, guess what? It's a short story.
Ha ha! Psych! You want your advance back? No, that's not. Is that part of the deal? No. The only book I've sold that was finished was Possessed. So everything else that I sold on proposal, which is its own kind of stress. I sold 10 on a synopsis and 6 chapters, all of which got scrapped when I had to write the draft. It just, the 6 chapters, I mean, like, some of it, like, sequencing of that book stayed in those chapters, but basically everything got scrapped. I sold 359 off of, like, a one page. Same with the 2 book series that comes out, 2014 and 15, it was like a one page for the first book and like a paragraph for the second. So I was like, what the hell happens in the sequel? Like, I know who the killer is. Like, I got all these characters, so I know who the killer is. Woo! So, I'm not sure how much I love writing on deadline from proposal. It's been a different kind of stress. But it is sort of nice to not have done all the work first, I guess. And I think I might be the person that can only write when there's a sort of figurative gun to my head. I think I write best when there's somebody like, come on, Gretchen, come on, deadline, come on, do it, come on.
Well, and then there are those writers like Caitlin R. Kiernan, who writes Dark Fantasy, and she sells all of hers on, you know, proposal, but then the novel that she ends up delivering is absolutely nothing like what she proposed.
That happens,
and
yeah.
They just take it.
Absolutely.
No, this is all bullshit.
Yeah.
You'll give me money, and it'll all be done.
Yeah, the book that I'm editing right now, it's called Get Even. It's the first book in this Don't Get Mad series that I'm writing. It's a contemporary. I pitched it as John Hughes with a body count. So, I do think they were expecting a slightly darker novel. I mean, there's dead people in it, but I mean, dead bodies, not dead people. I guess there were people, whatever. But it turned out significantly funnier than I was anticipating, and I had so much fun writing all the comedy with some of these just like really bizarre characters, like Ed the Head, who sells all the junk food contraband at school because all the vending machines only have health food in them. And so he has like a black market selling candy bars and like Ho-Ho's out of his backpack. And I was just like, I gotta put him in every scene because he's so funny. So that was, they got it and they were like, I like it, but this isn't quite what we were expecting. And like, oops. Sorry. So that's, yeah, that's its own thing. Sorry, that was a tangent.
What was the line from the Odyssey that you had tattooed on your back?
It's actually from the Iliad, and it is from Hector's speech in book 6, where he basically says, and as for fate, no man escapes her, good or bad, once he's born. It tickled a lot. It wraps around a little bit, so once it got to the side, I was like, you can't do that, don't mess up.
Nicole?
If you could be a character in any of each other's books, like any of the ones that have come out yet, who would you be?
Well, I know instantly.
Nice.
Yeah,
wow.
I'd be the girl from Zed.
Bridget. Bridget's awesome. Ooh. Bridget, first of all, having a half-Asian character in YA 2001 was not too common.
And to have her on the cover.
And to have her on the cover. Well, this, of course, the story of the cover is that the original girl on the cover was white. And she had big, like, Keira Knightley round eyes. It's like, round eye? You put round eye on this book? And I really was like, dear HarperCollins, I love you guys. But if you publish it with this cover, I will not defend it. Because I'm not going to be like, yeah, she could totally be half Asian. Because there was no way. And so they photoshopped her eyes to make her look like she was part
Asian. Oh, really?
Yes. And if you look at the there's copies of it somewhere. If you look at the cover, there's a lot of shadowing under her eye, and that's where the original eye came from.
I had no idea.
Yeah, I was like...
Well, they did a good job photoshopping.
They sure did, because I really was like... And they were like, here, I don't know if this is New York, no offense to New York, but they were like, she kind of looks ethnic. I'm like, what does that mean? I'm like, if... And then I had this moment where I was like, if my last name was like... Chow, would you be saying this to me? Is it because my name is Gretchen McNeil that you can be like, yeah, she sort of looks Asian? Like, if I was Asian, would you be saying that to me? It was very, very strange. So I put my foot down on that. But yes, I love Bridget a lot.
I've never heard that story before.
I tell it in small gatherings where no one would possibly put it on the internet.
Do you want me to not
do
that?
It's a story that I tell freely. And, it's one of those, covers are corporate decisions, and you get a bunch of talking heads around a room and they can convince each other that the sky is purple. I guess it is purple sometimes, but you know what I mean. And I really feel like this was one of those cases where, they all convinced each other that this was perfectly acceptable. And I took one look at it and I was like, nope. So I think I would guess that the cover model might have been Persian. Just looking at, she's all, she's blue and vines and stuff. And I think that's what they were thinking. Well, she doesn't look like she's Irish, And I'm like, well, she doesn't look like she's Chinese either. So I would definitely want to be Athena because I've always had an Athena fetish. Ooh. Not in a sexual way. But she was always my favorite of the Greek goddesses. The way she burst out of the skull and I was always down with that. So I haven't read this yet though, so I'm excited to read it, but it's on my Kindle.
Strangely enough, the cover for Girl of Nightmares, mm-hmm. people often ask if she's Asian. Really? And they're like, oh, is she Asian? I'm like, well, no, she's not.
I wonder what they see in that.
I don't know. I'm like, she's